would love to. And for those of you who don't know, that's one of my favorite songs.
What does it say?
First and foremost, thank you all for being here. It was a lovely evening. I stood on the Miss India New England platform last year, and I made you guys a promise. I promised that I would make you guys proud. Did I do that?
Yes. Yes.
Really? That's what I did. It's a very emotional moment for me because I feel like this is the platform in which I was first introduced to the community in 2012. And then I was recognized by my community in 2013. And now I'm saying goodbye to my community in 2014. And I don't get emotional very often. And I'm not a weak person. And I've seen everything life can possibly throw at a person. But one thing that can melt the strongest of hearts or even the strongest of stones is this unconditional love that I've felt from my community and everyone that I've ever interacted with. And I don't know what I've done to deserve it, but from my community, from Ruchka Didi, from the Madmankla Nilamanti and Nishianti, like, I've had so much support. And, you know, when I came, I did an interview with India New England. I've been telling you guys, yes, I did sign a couple movies in Bombay. And I still can't take in what's happening in my life. That's how magical I feel things are for me. And I stand before you, and I don't know why I deserve this over somebody else, but I am so grateful. I am so grateful for all the love, for all the support, and for everything that you guys have ever given to me. I am and always will be a Bostonian girl, and I hope and pray that my feet always stay on the ground, and if I ever, ever show any kind of ego, you all have the right to smack me across the face. But I want to really, from the bottom of my heart, thank Ruchika Didi, because I was a senior in college when I first was introduced to Ruchika Didi. It was for a Valentine's Day fashion show that I never did. But in 2012, when she did the pageant, she reached out to me and she was like, you know what, Monica? I believe in you. And I think all it takes is that one person to light a fire in your heart, to show you that you can do something, that you have potential, and to light the way, and then things start moving. And she was that one person for me, and I don't think anything that I've done so far would have happened had it not been for her. So thank you so much. The other thing that I think is very important is that when I was a freshman in college, I learned the hard way that life isn't all fun and games. I'm not gonna get into what happened and how that happened, but, and then I promised myself, after seeing how hurt my family was, I promised myself that I would always value life. I would always value my life. I would value the life of my loved ones. And every time I wake up in the morning, I'm thankful for this life because I understand how fragile it is. I promised myself that I was gonna go out and do anything that I set my heart to. And I've done that. And God's been kind, and my parents have been supportive, and I'm so happy for that. And for that, I wanna thank my parents for always being my rocks and for helping me out in some of the most difficult times of my life. Life, like I said, isn't all sunshine and rainbows, and I'm living in Bombay now, and like I said, living alone is awesome. Bombay's had its difficult times. I've faced a lot of rejection. I've been turned down a lot. But through rejection, you always come out stronger. You have a little bit of introspection. You learn a thing or two. But Bombay's all fun and games, like I said, but there's nothing like coming back to love into this community. So I want to wrap it up by saying, like, yeah, I'm giving away my title. But a crown is just that, a crown. It doesn't mean anything because what I got was worth much more, and that was the love of everyone in this room. So thank you all. Have a great night.
Monica Gill, Miss India New England 2013, in appreciation of completion of one term with grace and beauty.